Hello everyone, welcome to Sources Classes. So in this video again, we'll be continuing our discussion with respect to questions pertaining to that quantitative aptitude section of the paper. So if you talk about the QA section in general, this year round the questions seem to be a little bit on the difficult side. That is, they required more time as far as solving the same, and they were more calculation intensive. Also, they required an in-depth understanding on the subject matter just to solve them. Okay. So having said that, what we'll be doing in this video is we'll be taking a particular question from the paper itself, there is a QA section. And subsequently, we'll try and solve them so that whenever we come across questions such as this further down the line, we are easily able to solve these questions. Okay. So, having said that, let's take a look at the question at hand. A shopkeeper purchases 500 shirts at rupees 400 per shirt. Okay. And it sells 400 of them at rupees 500 per shirt. Find the overall profit and loss percent. Okay. Let's take a look. So, purchase. So 500 shirts at rupees 400 per shirt. Okay, so therefore CP of 500 is given as 500 into 400, that is 20. Okay, so this is my cost price for 500. Now I'm talking about a selling price. So he sells 400 shirts at 500 rupees 500 per shirt. So therefore, selling price of 500 in this case is given yes, this is what you have. So now what else we have? We have no real knowledge about the remaining 100 shares. Okay, so we have no real knowledge about what happened to those 100 shirts, whether he sold those shirts at a loss, whether he gave them these shirts for free or anything as such, we don't know. So it is really difficult. Whatever be the cases, he will earn a profit. Okay, either he'll earn a profit or no profit. No loss, that is break even condition, because the CP, which is this, is already matched here only. Oh, SP of 400, sorry, my bad. It's already matched here only. So, rest what happened with the 100 shirt, we don't actually know at what price he sent, whether he gained sent them at a price larger than 400 or larger than 500, or whether he gave this for free. So, we don't know. So it is not possible to determine the overall profit or loss percentage in this trade. Okay, so therefore in this particular case it cannot be determined. Okay, or if there was a C&D option, it would have been that, because we have no idea about 100 shares. Okay, so I hope it is clear to you why we arrived at this conclusion. So whenever we have such type of question wherein certain data is missing, so we need not assume anything. Like in this question, one might have thought that suppose he is purchasing 500 shirts for 400 per shirt, but then again he could have also purchased 400 shirts for 400 per shirts as well, so that we could have basically identify the CP for 400 shirts and then got the trade. But no, it doesn't work, because our entire transaction, because the entire transaction is involved of 500 shirts, so we cannot downcut that way. Okay, so in case you are looking for a detailed solution on the entire paper, feel free to connect with us. So for that, you can go through the description. There's a bunch of contact details using which you can get in touch with us. So any kind of doubt, you can seek us out that way. Okay. So if you like the video, make sure you like, share, and subscribe to the channel, so that we keep coming up with relevant content such as this further down the line as well. We'll be continuing our discussion similar sort of questions in the subsequent videos. Until then, I'm signing off. Thank you so much.